Hello dear friends and researchers. Myself Dr. Mona Samarthy, Department of Pharmaceutical Sciences, HNB, Garhwal University, Srinagar, Garhwal, welcomes you. Friends, we are back with another educational e-module on research indices series. This second part shall deal with the basics of H-index. We will be covering what is H-index, how it is calculated, what is its importance, and what are the limitations. So let us why we do the research. What is the benchmark of success for a researcher? The great scientist Edison answered this question in his famous quote: "Anything that won't sell, I don't want to invent. Its sell is proof of utility, and utility is success." So the success as a researcher lies in two main domains: productivity, that is invention, and impact, that is sale. H-index. So we do the research firstly to produce knowledge, product, services, that is productivity. Secondly, to disseminate our knowledge in research fraternity, that is impact. So as a researcher is recognized for his productivity, that is number of papers, and impact, that is number of citations. The H-index, sometimes called the Hirsch index or Hirsch number, is an author level matrix that attempts to measure both the productivity and citation impact of the publication of a scientist or a scholar. H-index measures simultaneously the quality and quantity of scientific output. H-index was solution given by physicist of University of California, San Diego, George E. Hirsch in 2005 as a tool for determining theoretical physicist relative quality. Later, it is used for assessing productivity and impact of a researcher, research group, or institution. It is an index that increases on the basis of citation and number of paper continuously with the passage of time. So now let's move to how H-index is determined. H-index is the number of papers of a person, group, or institution with citation number equal or greater than H. The definition of the index is that a scholar with an index of H has published H papers, each of which has been cited in other paper at least H times. Thus, the H index reflects both the number of publication and the number of citation per publication. For example, if a researcher's H index is 20, it means that out of his or her publication, 20 papers are cited 20 or more times. Now, who calculates the H-index? Automatic calculator, citation databases, Web of Science, Scopus, Google Scholar. Please remember, books, foreign language journals, patent, offline journals, not indexed, are not covered in these databases. Manual calculation, H-index can also be manually determined using citation databases. And it is to be noted, when mentioning the H-index in your CV or in grant application, do not forget to mention the source databases of the same. H-index depends on number of paper published and citations. Higher the papers and citation, higher would be the H-index. Next is subject and field of research. Science and researchers generally have higher H-index than researchers of arts. And within the same subject, same researchers working on hot topics are cited more than others. Third is presence of articles in the impact and accessible journal. The easy access and broad readership of a journal also increases the citation and hence the edge index. Next is stage of career. Obviously, a senior researcher would have higher edge index than new entrants or young researchers. Miscellaneous factors, type of papers, methodological papers, review papers, and innovative research paper. Pioneer researcher work or review papers are cited more, like Hirsch 2005 papers being pioneer in is cited highly and hence plays a vital role in improving its edge index. Edge index in career, edge index in academic recognition. In general, higher the edge index, greater the researchers in terms of productivity and citation impact. It's a great and simple measure of comparing the potential of scientists of the same field. In biomedical sciences, edge index is less than the number of experience. It indicates average or below average researcher. If edge index is equal to number of years of experience, indicates a successful researcher. If edge index is greater than number of years of experience, indicates outstanding and unique researcher. Now Hirsch observation career level. Hirsch observed scientist performance after 20 years. If edge index is 20, the level of scientist will be successful. If edge index is 40, the level of scientist will be outstanding, and if edge index is 60, it will be truly unique. Edge index in other disciplines and career level. Hirsch observed for physicists, if edge index is 12, it means that it is to be used for career advancement for associate professor at major research universities. If edge index is 18, he or she will be deserves full professorship. If edge index is from 15 to 20, the candidate deserves fellowship in American Physical Society. If edge index is 45 or higher, membership in United States National Academy of Sciences. London School of Economics in social sciences observe that if edge index is 2.8 in law and 3.4 in political sciences, 3.7 in sociology, 6.5 in geography, 7.6 in economics, a full professor in the social sciences had an edge index about twice that of lecturer or a senior lecturer, though the difference was the smallest in geography. So we can understand that edge index cannot be used to compare the researcher of different discipline. Now coming to the limitations. The databases coverage differs in publication sources and time range. Databases like Scopus or Web of Science differ in coverage of journal, so that the edge index calculated by two databases may differ. Simply, the difference in number of papers in different database is the basis of verifying edge index calculated by them. And the same holds true for coverage of time range. Second, limitation. It can be used only for comparing the same career stage and discipline. It is one of the prime limitation of we can compare like by like. Science researchers cannot be compared with humanity researchers, or young researcher or assistant professor cannot be compared with professor, or the scientist with 3-4 year experience cannot be compared with the scientist of 20 year experience. Simply the number of years would add up the research work for papers also. Third limitation, H index increases only and does not elicit the current impact or potential of researcher. Unlike impact factor, it increases only. We cannot assess the current credibility of researcher. Next, it invariably increases even if the author has stopped research or publication. Maybe a person with 49 H index have retired or may cease to the research currently, but you will see that even his H index will increase time by time. So now coming to the concluding remark, every researcher should be known by H index. So add it in your CV. Higher the H index, more the productivity in terms of impact of researcher. The H index is a major benchmark used by the employee or selection or recruitment and the assessment of researcher. Higher the H index is also an indicator of credibility of author, and it improves the confidence of reader and researcher following the authors. These are the bibliography for further readings. We'll be back with the other research indices soon. Stay tuned for more educational videos. Thank you for viewing. Please do share the video and subscribe our channel, Open Knowledge, for forthcoming videos.